My name is Soroush Zaghi. I'm an ENT sleep apnea surgeon, and we're here in our offices at the Breathe Institute, and welcoming Dr. Victor Abdullah from Hong Kong to join us to learn about the differences that we provide in our care for sleep apnea patients.
Oh, it's really wonderful to be here. It's my honor. I had the pleasure of watching Soroush doing a tongue tie release for one of his patients, and it was so impressive, every little thing that he did. I learned a lot from all his techniques, and I think oral myofunctional therapy is here to stay. It probably will complement the treatment of many of our patients, either as primary treatment or alongside surgery that we do. So it may be at least part of the missing link that wasn't quite with us in our armamentarium. And in future, after surgery, maybe we can prolong the effect of our surgery and make our surgery more effective.
Absolutely.
What do you think, Soroush?
Oh, absolutely. I have to agree that it's one of the most paramount features of my practice, so that all patients who get treated for sleep apnea get myofunctional therapy before and after their treatment, whether it's tongue tie or even if it's tonsils or nasal surgery.
Yes.
Because in a paper by Dr. Guimineau, we've expressed that the ultimate goal is continuous nasal breathing. And to achieve that, there are structural issues that we can achieve with surgery, but there are functional behavioral issues that require therapy. Just like if you do orthopedic therapy, you know, you do a knee replacement or joint replacement, you're gonna need to have to do some physical therapy to get that patient functioning again. Similarly, when you're a life of tongue tie with the tongue tethered to the floor of the mouth, or open mouth breathing, you have to re-educate them how to breathe through their nose. And it's very difficult for a lot of patients, because for me and you, we say lift up your tongue, they can do that. But for other patients, telling them to lift their tongue is like telling them to move their ears. It's a very odd sensation, and they need to have some therapy and some assistance to achieve those goals. So
yes,
I think there's a lot of hope in this field. But I'm really honored that you're here, and I wanted to learn a little bit more about, if you don't mind introducing for our audience, where you come from and how you ended up where you are.
Well, I come from Hong Kong. Of course, the Asian facial skeletal structure is slightly different from Western structure. And most people in the Western world, they have very stout and square jaws with very pronounced sort of chin. Whereas in Hong Kong and in Southeast Asia, perhaps more than Southeast Asia region, they have much smaller jaw and a slightly retronathic chin, and that has been shown in various papers in the past. So the sort of treatment they require might be slightly different from just soft tissue treatment, or at least it cannot be predominantly soft tissue. I mean, they probably will need some facial skeletal surgery to actually improve their airway. But even then, even after surgery, although many of them have initial improvement, they tend not to last. And I can imagine that if you leave a little bit of obstruction, a little bit of compromised airway, the sort of suction and the breathing will lessen tissue over time. So there is still a missing link in the tissue inside these patients that we can try and improve with other means. And myofunctional therapy, as Soroush has put it, is a very important adjunct to the treatment of these patients. I'm so glad you talk about nasal breathing, and it was very interesting. You remember that paper in children when they use cone beam to look at the airway. The actual airway, the pharyngeal airway in children, when they have nasal breathing, is a lot larger than as compared to oral breathing in these children.
Yeah.
And we know a lot about children now that even with tonsils and adenoids, tonsillectomy, adenoidectomy, their sleep apnea may not be totally treated.
Right.
Now, it can be multifold. It could be that skeletal problems or their skeleton growth might have been affected by these big tonsils and adenoids, and they need more help,
mm-hmm.
which translates into rapid maxillary expansion and other orthodontic or even orthognathic technique. But now with myofunctional therapy, I have some hope that maybe alongside tonsillectomy and adenoidectomy, these children, when subjected to oral myofunctional therapy, they can be spared
mm-hmm.
from some of these procedures. At least some children may be able to be spared from some procedures. So I hope that happens. And really the essence of it is to allow both adults and children to naturally place the back of the tongue, not the front of the tongue, mm-hmm. back of the tongue, to the top of their hard palate. That is very difficult to do naturally. We think about it, and then a lot of us, we don't do it. Mm-hmm. But in order to do it well, we have to keep our lips closed and to move the back of the tongue up to touch the hard palate. That is very difficult. And in order to relearn that, is our expert oral myofunctional therapist,
that's right.
who can help them. And of course, alongside your tongue tie release, it could be pulled down by a tie that never came to our notice in the past. So now with the tongue tie release that goes further back, not just the front bit, but further back, allows this to happen. And the natural breathing of the children or maybe adults will help keep the tongue, back of the tongue upwards by creating this negative pressure, the suction pressure via the side. So it's all very interesting.
It's all very interesting.
I don't know what will happen,
yeah.
how it would evolve over the next 2 years or so, but certainly a lot of information is around. We have to test it out.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I have to test it in the Asia region, and you do it in the
West,
and we'll join force.
That sounds great. That sounds great.
And we'll exchange ideas and experience and help improve things for the better care, quality care, patients.
And it's so great that you're open-minded and willing to explore.
I think we are all open-minded.
Yeah, you have to be.
We are very honest and frank about our results,
right.
success or failures.
Right.
That's how we learn.
Right. That's exactly right.